Did all the bands get along?
Yeah, of course.
There's no,
No, you would have heard about it in the news somewhere. It was fun. Yeah, I've done jams like that before. I've been on stage with Tool. I've done other things like that, so I'm a little used to it. I'm kind of like aware of what it feels like.
I saw the video, and I saw you up there, but I didn't see the other guys. What was that about?
Well, the other guys, they don't jam. They don't do that kind of thing.
No, okay.
And I'm the only one that kind of goes out and I'll play with other musicians and, you know,
right.
Just jam on the fly, you know, just whatever.
That's cool.
And it's an easy song, so. Amazing. I mean, you know, how can anything like that not be, you know, less than exciting?
Did you ever think something like that would ever come to fruition? You know, did you ever think it would happen?
No, never. Never. It was a shock. But you know what? It's, I think it's very long overdue.
Any rumors regarding maybe like a stateside version of the Big Four?
I haven't heard anything. But I don't see why it wouldn't happen. Good. Everything has been excellent. There hasn't been any drama. There hasn't been any kind of words between anybody. It's been peaceful. It's been great.
Why was the decision made to play Seasons of the Abyss from start to finish?
I think the agents, after the cancellation of 2 to 3, you know, the tours, you know, during Tom's, operation, you know, I guess the promoters wanted something that would keep the fans interested, and, you know, they requested, you know, shit like that.
Any plans on maybe doing other albums in their entirety, like South of Heaven, or I know it's the anniversary of Hell Awaits, right?
This is only something that, you know, promoters request or agents, or, you know, if it's part of a show or something, you know, but otherwise we don't go out of our way to try to, perform these records like this. It seems like we were the first ones to do Rain and Blood, you know, and now it seems like everybody and their mother is doing their record, you know, doing their entire record. I don't know if we have to do Seasons of the Abyss. I hope we don't, because I miss the other songs, you know. There's a lot of other songs that are as exciting,
right,
if not more fun to play drums to.
You guys sometimes shoot videos, like promo videos. I know there's one for World Painted Blood, but it's kind of an animated thing.
I'm sorry, it sucks. I don't like it.
Would you rather shoot like a live type thing, like you went to Egypt and shot Seasons of the Abyss?
I'd rather not waste the money at all.
Not shoot a video at all?
What's the point? Really, there's no point. Much Music, Viva, Germany, that's it. And just something for YouTube video watchers to, you know, to look at all the time. It's, it, I don't think videos have the same effect, at least for metal bands today, than what they did in the past. Because the whole MTV thing has changed. The end of the world, apocalypse, you know, typical Slayer stuff. I mean, you're not going to get anything really deep from me, because I didn't write the lyrics. So, I mean, it's just, it has to do with the end of the world and this whole scare, this whole 2012 thing, and, you know, your typical, you know, war, you know, jihad stuff. As it flows smoothly down my skin, intoxicating my soul.
Do you personally keep an eye on politics or what's happening in the world?
No. Nope. No opinion. Don't care. I don't take sides. I'm a musician. Yeah. And that's it. I think this album really reflects, I think, a real mature Dave Lombardo, because it's really thought out real well. You know, the drum rolls are thought out. And, I did on this record everything I've ever wanted to do on a Slayer record. I was given the chance. You know, the producer kept the sound the way I wanted it. And I feel like the sound and the performances. Eternity waits for you.
Some people have criticized the guitar tones or kind of low on the mix.
Oh, yeah.
I think it sounds great. But
guitar tones, oh, yeah. Everybody complains about something. You know? Yeah. Everybody's got a degree in frequencies. Everybody knows guitar tones. Everybody's got some kind of beef. You know what? Every band has their sound. Everything develops in its own way. It is what it is. And Greg Fiddleman is one of the greatest producers of our time. End of story. Captured it in the world painted by. You don't want to revert to the past. You know, you always try to develop and you try to recreate yourself, you know, sonically and try to make the best. The core stays the same. The band hasn't changed in 30 years. The technology has changed. So what you're just trying to do is capture the band like you did back then, but with today's technology and without overproducing it. You know what? Everybody asks me anything you want to say, and I always say, "Oh, I can't wait to come to your town and kick ass." But there's got to be something more creative you have to say. You have to answer to that question, and I'll think of it. One day it'll hit.